super excited to be able to take this opportunity to introduce you to the new Antares 44 Hybrid. We've spent the last 3 days doing sea trials, and we are now aboard the boat. All systems are working, and I want to give you a very quick overview on how the hybrid works, and it's super exciting stuff. We're very excited about it. So first of all, let me show you this. You'll see here up on the panel, we've got the standard B&G. We have our Yanmar diesel. We also have the hybrid marine electric drive display here for port. We have the electric drive display for starboard, and then the Yanmar engine, which is off. We are running under electric right now. And then of course the B&G displays. So let's talk about how the hybrid works. We turn on the electric drives, and then all we have to do is simply put the throttle forward, as we are right now, and you'll listen, it's super silent. We are now moving forward. We have 66 amps that we are drawing from the drive at this moment. I'm gonna go ahead and go up to about 70, get up to 100 amps. So now we are going forward port, 100 amps. We're moving at a speed of 4.1 knots at 100 amps on the port side. We did testing today, and overall we were able to do about 4.3 knots at 100 amps, which is roughly gives us, if we just use one engine, 6 hours of motoring time, which would be anywhere from 20 to 24 nautical miles at 4 to 4.3 knots, which we think is overall pretty impressive. Second of all, let's talk about how do we take ourselves and go from hybrid to diesel. Well, it's very simple. If I put both my controls back in neutral, all I have to do is push the power button here. My Yanmar engine will turn on, and then my display will turn into generation mode. So as I start the engine, which I just did, so now we have the Yanmar working, and we'll give the Yanmar a minute here. It takes Yanmar a little bit longer than what takes them a while before their screen pops on, but I'll go ahead and start the motor forward. And what's really important now is I'm motoring forward on diesel, and automatically I have my display changed to generate. So we are now generating power back to the house bank of 40 kilowatts of Victron lithium. So you'll see here as I'm going forward, I will motor at about 1500 RPMs, and you will slowly see this generate start to ramp up as we start moving forward. So it's designed that way. It's not an instantaneous from 0 amps to 50 amps or 60 amps. It will slowly ramp itself up as we're moving forward. And we've got 70 amps. And this 70 amps, by the way, to be clear, is on a 52 or 53 volts. So this is not 90 amps on a 24 volt system. This is a 48 volt system. So you can see here, we're now at almost up to 100 amps of regeneration at 1500 RPMs on the Yanmar, moving forward with just one engine at 5 knots. Why is that important? It's important because I can still use, if I need to, my diesel engines and motor at 5 knots, 1500 RPMs, and be putting 100 amps back into the lithium batteries. So now you say, well, can I run my Yanmar diesel and an electric at the same time? And if so, how do I do it? Super simple. I simply take this starboard throttle, I move it forward, and now I am motoring with diesel on port, electric on starboard, and I'm drawing 55 amps off of my electric power, and I'm still generating 96 amps on the port side. So I'm motoring forward, putting a net of about 45 amps back in the house bank using both diesel and electric simultaneously. That is very impressive. So there's one more thing I want to talk about this whole process. And you saw the video that we posted a little bit earlier, and that's, this is all remote control on the electric side. So we have this little remote control. You know, guys like, I've got to watch where I'm going here. I'm actually motoring up the river. Guys like to have remote controls, but guess what? Your wife, your spouse, your partner can also use that remote control and control the boat. There's no more yelling required from someone on the bow when you're anchoring. you can simply use that remote and back the boat up, move the boat forward, and also pivot the boat, all without leaving the anchor. No one required to be at the helm. So, as I said, we are super excited to have this hybrid back on the water, and the sea trials have been great. We are looking forward to providing you much more information on Jerome and his beautiful boat, Lana. Jerome, thank you very much for letting us use your boat. We're super excited. You want to show everybody here that's in here? We're still finishing up our day of sea trials, so we'd like to just say thank you, Jerome, Dave, everybody else.
We are super happy. Thank you, Mark.
Yeah. All right. Thanks again, and stay tuned. We will be providing even more technical details on the hybrid solution.